Good morning, friends. Today I will be discussing with you about gas power cycles. In gas power cycles, the thing to remember is that these are also called as air standard cycles, because here the working fluid is air. So in today's video, I will be talking you of auto, diesel and dual cycle, how to develop their efficiency expressions, and if time permits, then we'll also compare these cycles on different standards. So let us take the first cycle, that is auto cycle. Auto cycle comprises of two isochoric processes and two isentropic processes. So two isochoric and two isentropic processes comprises a auto cycle. Here is one in front of you in PV diagram. Firstly, air is compressed isentropically from 1 to 2, then heat is added isochorically from 1 to 3, then work, that is expansion, is done from 3 to 4 isentropically, and then 4 to 1 heat is rejected isochorically. So efficiency is defined as net work output to that of heat input. Now net work with respect to cycle, net work is same as net heat transfer, so it will be Q1 plus minus Q2 divided by Q1. This minus sign symbolizes that this much amount of heat is leaving the system. So this will be 1 minus Q2 by Q1. So what is Q2? Magnitude of Q2 basically, it is the isochoric heat rejection. So it will be isochoric, huh? So it will be MCV T4 minus T1. This is the magnitude of heat rejection, direction we have already considered. And what is the magnitude of heat addition? It will be MCV T3 minus T2, as this is isochoric as well. So this will get cancelled out and it will be 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2. The thing to remember here is, as we are talking of air standard cycle, so the air will be considered as an ideal gas, and Cp and Cv values will be independent of processes, that is they will be considered as constants. So if we take T1 common from numerator and T2 from denominator, then we will get T4 by T1 minus 1 divided by T3 by T2 minus 1. Okay, so this is the case. So if you talk of process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, now we know that PV to the power gamma is a constant. This is for an adiabatic process, and if we talking of ideal gas, then PV is equal to MRT. So if we replace P by MRT upon V, then we will get V to the power gamma into T upon V is a constant, or TV to the power gamma minus 1, it is a constant. So for process 1 to 2, I will write T1 V1 to the power gamma minus 1 will be same as T2 V2 to the power gamma minus 1, or T2 will be T1 V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. Now here we define a term R known as compression ratio, that is total volume to that of clearance volume. Again writing total volume to that of clearance volume here. This is the total volume of cylinder from outer dead center to the head of cylinder, and this is the clearance volume. This is total volume. So as process 2 to 3 and 1 to 4, 4 to 1, they are isochoric, so this can also be written as V1 is same as V4 and V2 is same as V3, so this will also be equal to, what is V1? It is same as V4, so it will be V4 by V3. sorry. So this is for process 1 to 2. So T2 will be equal to T1 R, that is compression ratio to the power gamma minus 1. Now come to process 3 to 4. 3 to 4 process again, isentropic reversible adiabatic process. So I can write T3 V3 to the power gamma minus 1 will be T4 V4 to the power gamma minus 1, or T3 is equal to T4 V4 by V3 to the power gamma minus 1, or it will be T4 R. Again, this from here is compression ratio to the power gamma minus 1. So if we compare this and this, then we can say that T2 by T1 is equal to T3 by T4, and that is equal to R to the power gamma minus 1. On slightly rearranging this, we can write T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. How? Bringing this T4 this side and T2 this side, so you will get this. T4 by T1 is same as T3 by T2, and look here, this is this, so they will get cancelled out, and efficiency expression will simply be T1 by T2. So replacing the value of this, here you will get 1 minus T1 by T2, which is 1 minus 1 upon T2 by T1, that is 1, and what is T2 by T1? It is R to the power gamma minus 1. Therefore, the auto cycle efficiency is defined as 1 minus 1 upon R to the power gamma minus 1. Here, the thing to be remembered or noted is that in case of auto cycle, as we increase the compression ratio, what will happen? Look, so if you are varying your efficiency with compression ratio, if compression ratio is 1, then efficiency is 0. This will be the, and as we increase the compression ratio, efficiency will increase, but it will reduce afterwards. Why? The question is, why efficiency is not continuously increasing with compression ratio as suggested by this equation? The reason being, as we increase the compression ratio, then the temperature in the cylinder after the compression will be enough to ignite the charge or the petrol, as auto cycle is applicable for petrol, to ignite the petrol before the sparking took place in that engine, that is pre-ignition, and hence leading to detonation, and that is high noise and vibrations. So that's why its efficiency reduces after some compression ratio, and this will also be the case with the this adiabatic exponent. As we go on increasing the adiabatic exponent, this will increase like this, but again reduces because of that same effect. Now with respect to auto cycle, people are also interested in knowing what is the mean effective pressure of auto cycle. Now how we define mean effective pressure of auto cycle? The mean effective pressure of auto cycle represented by PM is defined as the net work output from the auto cycle to that of heat to that of swept volume. Again, if we plot auto cycle on PV diagram, 1, 2, 3, and 4, so this is total volume. This volume is basically the volume swept by piston from moving from outer dead center to inner dead center, or bottom dead center to top dead center, and this is my clearance volume. So net work means what? The amount of work supplied by this cycle, that is in expansion, that is W 3 to 4, plus the amount of work given, plus minus W 1 to 2. Now you must be wondering why I am writing negative sign here. The reason of writing negative sign here is because we are, now you can write it W12, negative sign will come automatically. Now write again, at this is a reversible adiabatic, so it will be P3 V3 minus P4 V4 upon gamma minus 1 plus from 1 to 2, that is P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon gamma minus 1, or P3 V3 minus P4 V4 upon gamma minus 1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. So this is written in this. Basically what I did here, I have added the work interaction. I have not talked of work transfer, because if I am talking of work transfer, so this is the work transfer, this is the work transfer means this is the work transfer to the system, that's why it is positive, and this is the work transfer from the system, that's why it is negative. And if I am talking about only work interaction, so this will be good, no problem, same thing. So you do one thing, you take gamma minus 1 as common from both the expressions, and you will get P3 V3 minus P4 V4 minus P2 V2 plus P1 V1. Now you look this process, you will come to conclude that P2 by P1 is R to the power gamma, that is P2 by P1 will be V1 by V2, and V1 by V2 is what? Gamma R, and that is compression ratio. And this will also be equal to V1 by V2 is always be equal to V3 by V4 and what is, sorry, V4 by V3 and what is V4 by V3? It is nothing but P3 by P4. So if you look this, so you can write P4 by P1 is same as P3 by P2. So let us say this is my pressure ratio. Now, one more, why I'm writing this? Because I will be writing every pressure, that is P3 and P4, in terms of P2 and P1, and you already know that V2 is same as V3 and V4 is same as V1, because they are what? They are isochoric processes. So this network will now, can now be written as network as 1 upon gamma minus 1. What is P3? It is P2 RP. What is V3? It is V2 minus, what is P4? It is P1 RP. What is V4? It is V1 minus P2 V2 plus P1 V1. Friends, from here and here you can take P2 V2 common, and from here and here from you can take P1 V1 common. So do that, you will get P2 V2, here RP is there, 1 will come from here. Here you take minus P1 V1 as common, and you will get this. So in both the cases you have this RP minus 1 as common. So you will get gamma minus 1 P2 V2 minus P1 V1 RP minus 1. Okay. Now you do one thing, you take P1 V1 common. So P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1 P2 V2 upon P1 V1 minus 1 RP minus 1. Now what is P2 by P1? P2 by P1 is R to the power gamma. What is V2 by V1? Sorry, what is V2 by V1? V2 by V1 is basically inverse of compression ratio. So this will be P1 V1 gamma minus 1 P2 by P1. You know it is R to the power gamma. What is V2 by V1? It is 1 by R minus 1 RP minus 1. So what is my network output of this auto cycle? It is simply P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1 R to the power gamma minus 1 minus 1 into RP minus 1. Sorry. So this is the case. Now what is mean effective pressure? It is this work output upon swept volume. And what is swept volume? It is this much. That is total V1 minus this clearance V2. So this will be you take V2 common from denominator, you will get P1 V1 Now V1 by V2 in numerator and V1 by V2 in denominator, and V1 by V2 is compression ratio. Hence the mean effective pressure in case of auto cycle is given by P1 R this is divided by R minus 1. So remember this, this is mean effective pressure in case of auto cycle. Now moving ahead towards diesel cycle. Sorry. D-I-E-S-E-L, diesel cycle. Diesel cycle comprises of four processes in which one is isochoric, another one is isobaric, and two isentropic processes. Now, this is your pressure volume diagram for this diesel cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, firstly, compression, reversible adiabatically, we are compressing the air. Then, heat addition from 2 to 3, isobaric heat addition. Then, reversible adiabatic expansion, and then isochoric heat rejection. So, it is heat rejection, it is heat addition. One more thing is that if you look the total volume, it is this. And out of this volume, we are supplying heat till this volume. So we define a volume known as cutoff ratio. That is the ratio of V3 by V2. That is the point where we are stopping the fuel supply, or we are stopping the heat flow to that of point V from where we have started the heat supply. And our compression ratio will be as usual, that is V1 by V2. Okay, now you look again, so efficiency of this will be 1 minus Q2 by Q1 as usual, that is heat rejection, heat input. So it is 1 minus, what is Q2? It is same as MCV, T4 minus T1 as constant volume process. And this is the magnitude only, sign we have already considered. Here Q1, it is MCP T3 minus T2. Okay, so this will get cancelled out and you will simply get 1 minus T4 minus T1, divide this by, what is CP by CV? Is as adiabatic exponent gamma T3 minus T2. Now in this case, what I'll do is, I'll start from here, move towards the whole, fill the whole domain, that is starting from every process and finding out every temperature in terms of this temperature. So start it. So for process 1 to 2, it is simply T2 V2 to the power gamma minus 1 is T1 V1 to the power gamma minus 1, or T2 into T1 V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. Now, this V1 by V2 is R, so it will be R to the power gamma minus 1, okay? So this is T2, is T1 this. Now for process 2 to 3, it is a isobaric process. So we know P3 V3 upon T3 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2 for an ideal gas. So this 2 and 3 pressure, they are same. So what I can write T3 as T2 into V3 by V2. What is V3 by V2? We have already suggested it as cut-off ratio. So it will be simply T2 RC. Now what is T2? T2 is T1, R to the power gamma minus 1 and into RC. So this is T3 in terms of T1. Now come to process 3 to 4. For process 3 to 4, isentropic process. So T3 V3 to the power gamma minus 1 will be T4 V4 to the power gamma minus 1, or T4 will be T3 V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1. Now V3. What is V4? V4 is same as V1. So it will be V1 to the power gamma minus 1. You do one thing. You multiply and divide this in bracket term by 2. V2. So it will be V2 into V2 upon V1 to the power gamma minus 1. What is V3 by V2? It is RC. And what is V2 by V1? It is 1 by R, so it will be this. Replacing the value of T3, you will get T1 R gamma minus 1 RC into RC upon R to the power gamma minus 1. So look, friends, R to the power gamma minus 1 here, R to the power gamma minus 1 here, they will get cancelled out, and you will get T1 RC into RC to the power gamma minus 1. That is T1 RC to the power gamma minus 1 plus 1, that is RC to the power gamma. So replacing, so you have got this, what is this? This was T4. So you have got everything in terms of T1, now replacing everything in this expression. And you will get eta as 1 minus T4 is T1 RC to the power gamma minus T1 divided by gamma T3. What is T3? T3 was T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 RC minus T2. What is T2? It is simply T1 R to the power gamma minus 1. You do one thing, you take from numerator T1 common and from denominator T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 as common, and you will get 1 minus T1 RC to the power gamma minus 1 upon T1 R to the power gamma minus 1. Gamma is already there, so it will be RC minus 1. So this will get cancelled out. So the final expression for diesel cycle efficiency is 1 minus RC to the power gamma minus 1 whole divided by gamma R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC minus 1. Now this is all about diesel cycle. Now you come to a cycle which is combination of these two cycles. That cycle is known as dual cycle or limited pressure cycle sometimes, or mixed cycle as well. So let us talk of dual cycle. What we do in case of dual cycle, this is the case. We supply partially heat at constant, this is compression 1 to 2, partially heat we supply at constant volume, and then at partially at constant pressure. Why we say it as a limited pressure cycle? Because what we are doing, if you look here, this is your Otto cycle. One to two, and then three, and then four. So what you are doing here is, you are supplying heat totally at constant volume, and because of which the pressure is rising very high. So if you want to limit the pressure in the cylinder, what you do, you supply the same amount of heat, but you supply till this moment constant volume and then constant pressure like this. So as you are also supplying the heat at constant pressure in case of dual cycle, so it is becoming dual, because it is having characteristic of both Otto as well as diesel. So the amount of heat you are supplying firstly at constant volume and then at constant pressure, and this is your heat rejection. So the amount of heat supplied, total amount, will be Q1 prime plus Q1 double prime. So what is this? What is Q1 prime? It is constant volume heat supply. So it will be mCV T3 minus T2. What will be Q1 double prime? It will be mCp, because it is at constant pressure, T4 minus T3. What is heat rejection? It will be simply mCv T5 minus T1. So the efficiency expression will be 1 minus heat rejection. Heat rejection is Q2 and heat addition is Q1. So this efficiency expression will be 1 minus CV T5 minus T1 divided by CV T3 minus T2 plus CP T4 minus T3. You divide numerator and denominator both by CV, then you will get 1 minus T5 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2 plus, it will be Cp by Cv, which is adiabatic exponent gamma, T4 minus T3. Now friend, here also, what we'll do, we will write every point temperature in terms of initial temperature T1. Now here again, we will be having our compression ratio, that is V1 by V2. We will be having our cutoff ratio, that is V4 by V3. But we will be defining new term here as we are talking of this constant pressure, constant volume also, pressure increasing. So pressure ratio, that is P3 by P2. So start process by process. For process 1 to 2, which is a reversible adiabatic process or isentropic process, so it will be simply T2 is equal to T1, V1 by V2, that is R to the power gamma minus 1, simply. For 2 to 3 process, this is what 2 to 3 is a isochoric process. So it will be P2 V2 by T2 is equal to P3 V3 by T3 as volume is constant. So we will get this temperature T3 as T2 P3 by P2. What is P3 by P2? We have already defined it as Rp. So this T2 we have developed as T1, R to the power gamma minus 1, and then this Rp. So you get this T3 also. Now for the process 3 to 4, this is a 3 to 4 process is what? Isobaric process. So I can write P3 V3 by T3 is equal to P4 V4 by T4, and as the pressure is constant, so this T4 will be T3 V4 by V3. What is V4 by V3? We have already defined it as cutoff ratio, and T3 is T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 Rp into Rc. Now come to process 4 to 5. What is 4 to 5? Is reversible adiabatic process. This one. So we can write T5 V5 to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to T4 V4 to the power gamma minus 1, or T5 is equal to T4 V4 upon V5 to the power gamma minus 1. Dosto, what is V5? V5 is same as V1, isochoric. So this T5 can be written as T4 V4 by V1 to the power gamma minus 1. And that will be T4. What is this? What we'll do now, we divide and multiply by 3, V3. What is V3? V3 is also equal to V2. So replacing this V3 as V2 upon V1 to the power gamma minus 1. Now, what is V4 by V3? It is simply cutoff ratio, Rc. And what is V2 by V1? V2 by V1 is R, 1 by R. So it will be this to the power gamma minus 1. Now replacing the value of T4, this, you will get T5 is equal to T4. T4 is T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 Rp Rc upon R to the power gamma minus 1. You have R to the power gamma minus 1, R to the power gamma minus 1 here, they will get cancelled out, and you will get T1 Rp Rc Rc to the power gamma minus 1. So this Rc to the power gamma minus 1, this Rc, you will simply, this will get cancelled out, and you will get T1 Rp Rc to the power gamma simply. So you have every temperature in terms of T1. This is T2 is equal to T1. This is T3 is equal to this. T4 is this. And finally T5 in terms of T1, like this. Now what we do, we replace every value in this efficiency expression. I'm writing this efficiency expression for you so that you can see it clearly. Once again, it was 1 minus T5 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2 plus gamma T4 minus T3. 1 minus T5. What was T5? We have developed it as T1 Rp Rc to the power gamma T1 as it is. Divided by what is T3? T3 expression was T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 Rp minus. What was T2? It was simply T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 plus gamma. What was T4? T4 was T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 Rp Rc minus T3. What was T3? T3 expression was simply T1 R to the power gamma minus 1 into Rp. So you do one thing, T1 is cancelling from every term. Okay, so this is 1 minus Rp Rc to the power gamma minus 1 in numerator. Now, from first bracket, you can take R to the power gamma minus 1 as common. And you will get Rp minus 1. From second term, if you see here R to the power gamma minus 1 and Rp, they are common. So R to the power gamma minus 1, Rp is common. In bracket, you will get Rc minus 1. And from both the things, you can take this R to the power gamma minus 1 is common. So the expression for this will be Rp Rc to the power gamma minus 1 whole divided by R to the power gamma minus 1 Rp minus 1 plus gamma Rp into Rc minus 1. Dosto, this is the expression for efficiency of dual cycle. The comparison of these will be dealt in the next lecture. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. If you liked my video, please do subscribe.